I would just like to say that when my father told me that he was having an interview today about his life in the Holocaust, it had me thinking about our family and how we were raised, and at what point in our life were we aware of my father's history. And I think that probably in our growing up as four daughters, we were very rarely aware that he went through a lot of suffering. We knew that, I think each and every one of us, although my sisters might want to speak for themselves, felt that there was pain that he felt and lived through, but at some level, it was a pain that was never discussed, so we were probably very unaware of his life. He wasn't a survivor that ever spoke of his experiences, so we came from an atypical children of the survivors in that we weren't burdened by any of his pain, nor would he have wanted us to know any of the details. And to this day, I don't think any one of my sisters has much detail that they could provide, and probably will have to look at this tape in order to learn about his life. So in that respect, I think that we were raised without a lot of knowledge. Until I was probably 25 and I went with him to the Ottawa Children of the Survivors Conference with my sister Marilyn over here, I think that was the first time probably that we became aware that we were children of a survivor. I don't think we actually ever thought of ourselves in that way. So I think in this family that's a unique experience, not having the usual upbringing of many other children. If anybody else wants to add to that.
I think what Edie said was right, although I would add from my own experience that I felt that my father being a survivor was very much a part of my life through my entire life, even if we didn't really know any of the details of it. Mm-hmm. We always felt somehow that my father had suffered something great on some level, and I think we all tried to be very good children for him to somehow compensate for the loss of his family and for all his suffering. We always wanted to make him happy as opposed to cause him any problems. And my mother as well sort of tried to absorb all of the problems so that my father only saw all the good things about his children and never had any more burdens or any more burdens than he had to have. And I think that was very important. But I think until I was in my 20s, I never really considered that my father had lost his family in the way that any of us could lose our family. And I remember asking him if he missed his parents and his brothers and sisters that he lost. I hadn't even really considered it that on that level, that he had lost his family that was as close to him as our family is to us.